About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And I can hardly believe it's already going to be Christmas. So our program this evening, we have some toy dogs for you. My guests are Kay Sivel, and she has Chinese Crested, and that was the lump of who knows what that you saw at the start of the program. There are actually two dogs there. My other guest is Connie Newcomb, and she has Chihuahuas. The one she's holding is a puppy. So she'll bring the big one out later. So I think we'll talk to Connie first about Chihuahuas, because everybody knows about Chihuahuas, right? We all know what a Chihuahua is, and you know. So suppose you tell us what actually a Chihuahua is.
Well, the Chihuahua is the smallest of all the toy dogs.
Okay.
Their average pedigree Chihuahua should weigh from 4 to 6 pounds.
Okay.
No more than 6 pounds for an AKC dog.
Okay.
And this is a long coat.
Oh.
This is a puppy. He's 3 months old. This is Jacques. His coat will get longer. He's really just has a baby
Jacques
coat.
Jacques is not a Mexican name.
No, he's actually from, he's from French Canada.
Oh.
So we named him Jacques. He's French, yes. So
a French Chihuahua.
Yes, he's a French Chihuahua. And so he will change a lot. He's just a puppy.
Uh-huh.
And right now he's about 3 pounds.
Okay.
So he'll be a good 6 pounds. They're great dogs. I love Chihuahuas. They're lots of fun. They love to sit in your laps. They're not a great dog for small children.
Right. Well, that's understandable, yeah. Especially, you know, young children.
Yeah. I would say, no, you know, maybe 10 years old,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
No younger.
Yeah.
Probably. They're just an all-around wonderful dog. I love the little ones. There, you can take them anywhere.
Yes. They're easy to, yes, that's true. You can take them anywhere.
They're easy to, and these dogs are so easy to groom. Also, in the show world, this even the long coats very easy. They're really wash and go. You do very little grooming on them.
Well, there's very little dog.
Yeah.
Of course, there would be very little grooming. You know, my breed, it takes about 3.5 hours.
Know,
you
this,
know,
well, it's that's like, that's another benefit of the Chihuahua.
This one, I don't even think is as big as my dog's head.
I know.
But now you mentioned long coat.
Mm-hmm.
Probably most people don't know that they come in two coats.
That's true. And they also come in every color except for brindle or merle. That's really not acceptable. Merles actually, they don't, because they have health issues, they don't
anymore.
But they come in every color, and the long coat is, I have to admit, before I got into Chihuahuas many
uh-huh.
years ago, I didn't realize there was a long coat Chihuahua.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Most people are familiar with the smooth coat.
Sure, that's
which
because
I
it's
happen
right,
to have.
Right. But that's what most people see.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Is the smooth coat. Mm-hmm. You don't very often see, and are they very popular? You know, the smooth coats are very popular, but you don't very often see a long coat. And people, I don't even think, well, that's not even a Chihuahua.
Yeah, and that's true. Most people will you know, think it's
something
other than
else.
A Chihuahua.
Something else, yeah.
In the show world, you see a lot of long coats, mm-hmm. actually, because
mm-hmm.
they are, for confirmation, you can hide some faults in
uh-huh.
a long coat,
uh-huh.
not necessarily in a smooth coat. And you see equal amounts of long and smooth.
Right.
I think in the pet world, you see mostly smooth coats.
Yes,
I think.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
walking down the street, if you saw Chihuahuas coming towards you, they would all be smooth
yes.
and not, you know.
Yeah. I mean, they're certainly out there, but you don't see as
right.
many long
that's
coats.
Exactly right.
Right.
That's exactly
mm-hmm.
right. So what color is he?
Right now, I think he would be called a fawn with sable markings.
Okay.
The sable might fade. Generally, in these puppies, you never know that he... I'm guessing he's going to get a little lighter. His mask
mm-hmm,
might completely
mm-hmm.
fade.
Okay.
He has a little markings on the ears.
Yeah.
But this puppy coat is going to change completely,
right,
pretty
right.
much.
Now, how long is this coat going to get? Like
longer,
like
I hope, because right
well,
now
yes,
it's,
well,
it's
yes,
pretty long.
Yes, we hope so, too.
He, you know, it's hard to tell. I've had long coats where they had hardly any coat, and then all of a sudden, by 6 months, they had a huge coat.
Okay, so do they get like ballish looking, or is it a nice smooth, like the crested? Is it going to be a coat like that?
No,
is it going to be that
it's
long?
Much more, it's a fluffier coat.
A fluffier coat,
it's
okay.
It's got a thickness, a little bit of a wave to
okay,
it.
Okay, so they look like little puff balls mm-hmm. then.
Yeah, it's
okay.
pretty, and they vary from dog mm-hmm, to dog. Mm-hmm. I mean, a fuller coat, of course, is preferred.
Right, right. So actually, what were they originally bred for?
As far
and they come
as
from Mexico,
I know,
right?
The breed is ancient, uh-huh. but it's the exact origin is not known. I mean, these go back to the Aztecs, but okay. they were hairless dogs, or
okay.
they were slightly larger from what they've seen uh-huh. Regarding these dogs. And then they were, I think, about 1850, they were found again in Chihuahua, Mexico, which is why they are called Chihuahuas.
Okay.
And then brought into the United States and introduced into the AKC in 1904.
Okay.
So it's a pretty old breed.
Yes.
By AKC standards, and just the fact that it can be traced back.
Right.
To the time of the Aztecs, basically.
Yeah. Huh, so, how about that?
Yeah. And they always have been only companion dogs. Their only function is to really sit in your lap and to be
a hand warmer.
A toy. I mean, it's a toy. And that's all they love to do. If you sit down, they will sit with you.
Wow.
And they're just, you know, that's why I think they're so endearing to most people.
Well, yeah, because it's like a toy. And I can imagine, you know, that women who are empty nesters probably love this, because all they need to do is, you know, instead of a baby, you have a little dog that you can hold and cuddle and carry around and stick in your purse. And
well, they are just so lovable.
Mm-hmm.
And when we, you know, my husband and I sit and watch TV, they just sit with us.
More like
that's all
more
they
like
want
cats.
To do.
Yeah,
kind of like cats. I mean, and they're very clean too. They're mm-hmm. They stay very clean, and they're easy to take care of.
Now, since they are small dogs, are they harder to housebreak?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I from my experience, and from what other people have told me, and unfortunately, I think that's a problem with people that don't realize they have to put more time and effort into a small
mm-hmm.
dog
mm-hmm.
because they're just harder. I don't know why they're harder, but they are.
Well, you know, if you look at the size, look at that size dog. I mean, you think of the size of the bladder.
You know, they go very often.
Well, they have to. I mean, it's a teeny little bladder, so they take two laps of water and they have to go.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, a lot of people that I know with toy dogs just keep newspaper out all the time
or
litter box train them.
Well, and that's the other thing. When it gets very cold out,
they don't want to go out.
It's very hard on them.
Mm-hmm.
And they are easy to paper train. Mine are all paper trained as well as outside trained. But it does take a little bit more care. And the other thing is, I think with people in Chihuahuas, is because they're little and they're so cute, you tend to spoil them.
Mm-hmm.
You tend to not treat them
mm-hmm.
like a dog. And they're dogs.
Right.
You
right.
must treat them like a dog and train them like a dog,
mm-hmm.
or you're going to have a problem.
Yes.
And sadly, this is why dogs end up in shelters,
right.
because people don't take the time to train them.
And I hear a lot of people say, oh, well, the dog is growling because he's protecting me. And it's like, come on, you know, he had a 5-pound dog here. What do you mean it's protecting
well,
you?
Well, they are. They're very possessive, but you have to train them. You
but,
can't allow it.
You know,
it.
When you're walking up to the person and the dog is already, it's like, wait a minute, I wouldn't accept that from a larger dog.
Right,
why
right.
are you accepting
well,
that?
This is a problem with
yes.
small dogs. People tend to spoil them and allow them to have bad behavior.
Uh-huh.
And then they can't understand why the dog
is
turns out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And I also volunteer at Peaceable Kingdom Shelter.
Okay.
And we have a lot of Chihuahuas, and
oh,
it just
really?
Breaks my heart.
Oh,
yeah,
that's
really
a shame.
Sad because they're great dogs.
Yes.
But I think that they're just, you know, end up there for who knows why, but I think a lot of it is training issues.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people think, well, it's a little dog, so
mm-hmm.
it doesn't really require very much care.
Exactly.
When that's not true.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
not true.
Yeah.
So do they need a lot of exercise? I mean, since it is a little dog, is it like a pug, like an Energizer bunny? Or
you know, they all have different personalities.
Okay.
I have some that are just nonstop and some that are lazy.
Okay.
But they do, I mean, they don't need a lot of exercise,
mm-hmm.
but they do need exercise.
Yeah.
And they do need
well.
To be walked, you know, to stay healthy
mm-hmm.
and so
mm-hmm.
forth. But as far as you know, a good walk, or we happen to have a fenced, double fenced in yard, double fenced in yard for the small dogs.
Yes, well, of course, you know, it's little holes, little dogs.
Yeah, and so they love to run around, but they don't require, of course, as much as a big dog.
Okay.
So they're good for, you know, people that do have apartments in small places.
Good, and they're not yappy.
You know, they can be, but they tend to be more yappy if there's multiples. I think
one starts the other.
Right, okay. Exactly. I you know, I hate to say they're yappy. They're really not.
Okay.
They're really not. I mean, they're curious, and of course they bark at the window if something's out there.
But well, of course.
They don't carry on, and I think if they are yappy, you're not giving them enough attention.
Okay. Okay.
You know, I think they need whatever exercise, socialization, whatever. Mm-hmm. They shouldn't be yappy.
Right.
I mean, sure, they do bark.
Well, of
like
course, they're dogs.
But I don't think they bark any more than
What is a teacup Chihuahua? I answer the phone for the kennel club, and I invariably get phone calls for teacup, you know, whatever, Chihuahua. And it's like, well, if it's only 4 to 6 pounds to begin with, how much smaller do you want? And maybe you just ought to go to the store and buy a stuffed dog.
I think people perceive a lot of Chihuahuas that are, you know, that you might get from a breeder that it's not a show quality dog.
Mm-hmm.
Chihuahuas can be 10 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
But the breed standard is 4 to 6 pounds.
Right.
And 6 pounds is what a Chihuahua should be. It's not a teacup Chihuahua. It is the standard size of a Chihuahua.
Why don't you get your big guy out?
Okay.
Give me
well,
this
he's
little
not
thing.
Much bigger.
Give me this little thing. Hi, sweetheart. How are you? Oh, my God. My puppy wasn't this small.
Rocky's like, oh, God, I want to get out of there. Hey, Rockstar.
Obviously, he's not a fawn.
No, he's and now he is. I'll just set him up here so you can hear Rock. Let's do your show thing.
Yeah.
This is a 6 pound dog, and you can see he's a grand champion. I mean, this is a really pretty dog, but that's 6 pounds.
Dog.
He's 6 pounds.
Yeah.
And so that's what a dog should look like. And he's a nice, healthy weight. You know, he's not thin. He's just a good size.
And they always have the peculiar head.
This is the apple head,
okay.
Which is what he's supposed to have—a nice rounded head, a little bit of a snippy muzzle, nice ear set, straight legs. He's scrunched up now, but a nice top line.
Well,
now Rocky happens to have a pretty curly tail. They shouldn't be this curly, but it's okay.
Yeah.
It should be a little higher.
What kind of health problems do these guys have since they are so small?
Actually, they're generally pretty healthy.
Okay.
What you do find and what you have to look out for if you're looking for a Chihuahua, they tend to have bad knees, luxating patellas, very common in the breed.
Okay.
They have dental problems like a lot of small
the toy
dogs.
Yeah.
It's very hard to clean their teeth.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Well, they're very small mouths.
Yeah. And it is very hard. And they tend to have dental problems. Some of them, you hear heart murmurs.
Uh-huh. What about eye problems? Since they do have the protruding eye.
The problem is the danger of injury for the protruding eye.
Okay.
I've never had that, thank God, but... because they have, you know, their eyes do.
Right.
And that's what they're supposed, you know, they're supposed to have that big eye.
Yeah.
And you just have to be very careful. But as far as other eye problems, they're generally healthy.
Good.
Generally healthy. They have a nice long lifespan, you know, 10 to 17 years on the average.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're very pretty.
Yeah. And so
he knows he's very pretty.
Yeah, he does. He really, he's a real show dog.
Yeah.
He loves to be a show dog.
And since you do show, you also wrote two books.
I did. I wrote two books.
Can we show the there you go. Confidential, which
dog
is...
Dog Show Confidential.
Uh-huh.
And that's Rocky.
Okay, that's Rocky right there.
And it's funny because when I started in the dog show world, and that was about 7 years ago, 8 years ago, 7 years ago, and, you know, people always ask me questions about dog shows. So I wrote a book about it, my experiences. So it was, you know, it was fun.
And you wrote another one as well, Dog Stories, with happy endings.
Yes, and that's Katie, she's a champion. And that's a kind of a collection of family stories that were really pretty funny, you know, from neighbors and friends.
Uh-huh. Yeah, a lot of us have very funny stories.
Yeah, I mean, for anybody who's ever loved a dog, it's just kind of a funny, happy, happy to eat. So, yeah.
If nothing else, dogs teach you humility, right?
Yeah. And, you know, we need happy stories about dogs.
Yes, we do.
We need happy stories.
Yes, we do.
There's a lot of sad ones.
Right.
So this is just kind of lighthearted and happy.
Very good. Okay, now suppose we look at the girls, the Chinese Crested. Now, last month we had on the Sholowe Kinsley. Yeah, Sholowe Kinsley. I hope I said that correctly, Jim. But anyway, these are another sort of hairless breed. There's one without hair and one with hair. And you said they're litter sisters.
They are litter sisters.
Oh, wow. Okay. So you can get whatever
Yeah, as long as you don't breed coated to coated, you'll have a variety of hairless and coated puppies.
Okay.
And Louise is a beautiful example of the hairless variety. And her sister Thelma is a beautiful coated powder puff. And they are double coated in the powder puff.
Okay.
And single coated, and you can see the difference in the lay of the
hair. One is fluffy and the other one's not. Now, do you think, what were they bred for?
These dogs have been companions to people since we can see back to the 1700s. They were bed dogs. They were known as healing dogs, where if you had something wrong with you, you would hope that they would heal you. And there's lots of legends of what they were bred for that have been proven to be more story and less fact.
Yeah.
They were traded by the Chinese merchants,
uh-huh.
and that's how they became known as Chinese, but they probably originated in Mexico like the rest of the hairless breeds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, isn't that interesting?
But they were given as gifts, and they have been just companion dogs all along.
See, don't you wonder where the hairless gene came from?
It is something that people have speculated about since...
It's like the chow with the blue tongue. Where did it come from?
Right.
The Dalmatians with their spots. Where did it come from?
Right.
And these guys don't have any hair. So, and why does it have hair on its head and not on its body?
Right.
You know, it has a little hair on its feet, a little hair on its tail. Mm-hmm. And you can get both kinds in a litter. It's just such an interesting breed.
It is an interesting breed. And they're such little characters. They've really earned their place in the companion world.
Mm-hmm.
They have just happy-go-lucky personalities. They're dear dogs. They're easy for all the family members to enjoy. They like everybody. They're not particular about, you know, one person is their only person in the family. They're good with kids.
So they're free with their love.
They are. They're not selective. Especially if you're on the couch, they're your best friend.
Oh, I can imagine. I can imagine.
Yeah.
Now, how with these guys, now, I can understand the coated one, but the uncoated one, you obviously have to put something on it, like on a day like today.
On a day like today, Louise has her little outfit on.
Do you want to hand one to me?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
they have... lots and lots of clothing that you can put on your dog, but we don't put it on to go outside to just go potty.
Oh, so they're okay?
Absolutely. You know, just to run out and go potty and run back in. But if we're taking a trip in the car, absolutely.
Okay.
If I need a coat, they need a coat. And the same with sun. A lot of people ask, do you have to put sunscreen on the dogs? And the dark colors like this tan nicely, and these are sun-loving dogs, as most dogs are. But the hairless as well can bask in the sun, and her skin will get darkened.
Huh.
And I don't put sunscreen on her. Sometimes it's so warm when we're out walking, I'll put a light colored t-shirt on her just to keep the sun from beating down on her too much, just as a protection. But we don't want to do too much to the skin. We want to feed a really quality diet.
Yeah.
And
So what kind of problems would you have with the skin?
Some dogs have pimply skin
or
blackheads or ingrown hair follicles.
Huh.
And what I have found is that my dogs don't have any skin problems.
Wow.
And we feed healthy food, fresh water, sunshine.
Yeah, and I think,
not a lot of stuff on their skin.
Yes.
And it does mean a lot.
Sure.
It means, a good, healthy skin. It's the same as a healthy coat.
Now, do you have problems with housebreaking them? Are they just paper trained?
We can say the same thing, that they take a little bit
longer.
All the toy dogs.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that a lot of it is from our approach to it. Oh, it's so small.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if the big dog did that in the house, we'd never allow it.
That's exactly right.
But we make exceptions because they're small or perhaps they can't go out. But I completely agree that they're dogs and they need to be treated like dogs.
Yes, yes.
And trained like dogs. And if we need to give them a spot in the house to go, they need to be, you know,
right. They have
trained to
have
that
to
as well.
So, yeah, I had a friend who had a toy dog, and she litter box trained it, and she thought that was fine. You know,
right.
Well, you have cats, and you clean it out. You know, this is just a dog, you clean it out.
Right.
But,
right.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Now, they also have problems with their teeth, too.
They do. The hairless gene is related to the dentation gene, and in the hairless, we sometimes see premolars missing, and it is allowed for in our standard, but we have good, healthy mouths.
Now, do you breed the hairless to the hairless?
You can absolutely breed hairless to hairless, and you can breed hairless to puff, and you can breed puff to puff, but you will result in just
all
puff
puffs.
Coats.
Oh,
yeah.
How about that?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It's very interesting. You know, it's like, what the heck gene is in here?
Yeah, genetics in
yes.
the Chinese Crested is
yes.
an
now,
amazing.
What color would you call them?
Louise is... They're both sable.
Okay.
They have rich browns and a deep dark brown black nose.
Oh. You can hardly see.
Yes, they
Thelma.
Have their head down from the
yes.
lights, I think.
Oh, the lights
but
shining in their eyes.
Yeah.
They're like princess dogs.
They
it's like,
are
you know,
like princess dogs. They really
do
are.
They need a lot of exercise? And you know, what about age of children? Would you get this for a young child, say maybe 5-6 years old, or
they're excellent with my 5-year-old grandson.
Okay.
Just
okay.
excellent, and they exercise a lot, but they're easier to exercise
well,
than
yeah.
say a sporting dog because they can do it in a smaller environment.
Right. Well, they run around the house and they get exercise, whereas
right.
you know my guy's
right.
running around the house. It's yeah. I have no house left.
Right. Well, these yeah. guys go around the outside of the house several times, and then you know they're
yeah.
ready
yeah.
to go back in.
Right.
But they're, you know, if we're going to sit in the house, they're happy to do it.
Yeah.
If we're going to be out in the yard, they're happy to be out there with you.
Yeah, great.
Whatever they're...
Great. So what kind of medical problems do they have?
We have eye problems in our lines.
Okay.
We have, luckily, markers that we can genetically test for.
Oh,
and we
good.
Do. And that's one of the reasons to get your puppy from a responsible breeder
mm-hmm.
who does genetic testing
yeah.
to help prevent diseases that
yeah.
are known in our lines.
Yeah, yeah. And the same with the knee? The
yeah,
slipping patella?
You see it.
Okay.
Yeah, you see it in patellas.
No
well.
other problems, though, other than?
We don't have much going on. They're relatively sturdy, healthy dogs.
Uh-huh. Who just love to be cuddled.
Yes.
Look at that.
Yeah.
And it seems like the one with hair wants to be cuddled closer gee. Than the one without hair.
It does indeed.
Oh, my word.
She
why,
is a cuddler.
Why did you select that breed?
I think the first Chinese Crested I saw just rocked my world. It was 1992. I saw her. I fell head over heels in love with her, and I had to have her.
Oh, my word.
And, oh, my goodness. What a great thing it has been.
Wow.
They've only been... latecomers to AKC
yes.
since 1992.
Yes.
But they've been, you know, around much, much longer than that, and in America a lot longer. But,
uh-huh.
you know, I'm glad
yeah,
for the people who have really dedicated themselves to bettering this breed so
uh-huh.
that we can enjoy a healthy, sturdy, robust dog.
And they live for a fairly long time.
They
as
do.
Well.
They have a nice long lifespan. Yeah. Yeah, 15 years is not
wow.
uncommon.
Yeah.
So it's nice to...
That's the good part of the small breed. You
it
know,
is,
they live longer
yeah.
than, you know, like
than
the Danes.
Yeah, oh,
the Danes
yeah.
8 years, 9 years,
right.
and we no longer have them.
Right.
Well, they certainly are adorable.
Thank you.
Oh, I see you got the puppy and you put the, you know, poor Rocky away. Poor Rocky who wanted to, you know...
He wanted to be the center of attention.
Yes, exactly right.
He
wanted to be the center
stardom.
Of attention, and now you stuck him away. Well, thank you, ladies, for being
on the
program. And obviously, since it is December, please do not get a puppy for Christmas. Do not get a puppy and say, oh, look what I bought for you. I know Norman Rockwell has a really cute picture, but Christmas is not the time for you to get a puppy. It's just too busy. If you want to get a puppy and present it as a gift, instead of getting the puppy, I wouldn't want somebody buying my puppy for me. I want to go and look at it and pick out my own. But give a leash, a collar, a book. Then when Christmas is over and all the hubbub has died down and the relatives have gone home and all it is your little family, then you go and pick out your puppy. The person who the puppy is for picks out the puppy. So until next month, good night.
About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.